Hi there, my name is Drew. I'm a representative from Jeep, and it is my pleasure to show you around the 2022 Grand Wagoneer. Now, this vehicle has been nearly 10 years in development, and it has been out of the market for almost 30 years. So there is a huge demand for a vehicle in this segment to be coming back, and we feel like Jeep has delivered with the brand new 2022 Wagoneer and Grand Wagoneer. Now, it will be available in 7 different trim levels. The Wagoneer is going to feature a 5.7-liter engine with an electronic assist that we call e-torque. And then the Wagoneer is the same size, the Grand Wagoneer is the same size, but it features a larger powertrain, a 6.4-liter powertrain with no electronic assist on it. It is a 3-row body-on-frame SUV. It's available rear-wheel drive or 4-wheel drive. We have several different 4-wheel drive systems available, all the way up to the top of the line, which is called Quadra Drive 2. It has available airlift suspension that we call Quadra Lift. You can choose from 5 different ride heights if you have that Quadra Lift suspension. This is a Grand Wagoneer Series 3. This would be the top of the line. It features power running boards. It features a 24-way adjustable driver's seat that includes electronic adjustments on your headrests. It is featuring in the center console up front, we have a cooling center console so you can put your beverages in that center console and keep them cool while you're driving. At the top of the line, it will feature a staggering 75 inches of total screen display. So that is including the front center screen. There is a lower screen below that front center screen that actually articulates up and down to reveal some hidden storage behind it, including some USB charging ports and a Qi wireless charging pad. It does feature a segment first co-pilot screen. So in the dash in front of the passenger seat, there is actually a screen embedded into that dash. That screen can be used to update the navigation destination. It can be used to change the media. And yes, the passenger can even watch television while riding down the road thanks to a privacy glass that's put on there. Only the passenger can see it. It will be invisible to the driver while the driver is operating. So we have been on the road with this vehicle since the first week of July. This has been our tour vehicle. We've put probably almost 3,500 miles on this vehicle since we started.
And have you been using the screen and the cooler up there?
We've definitely been using the cooler as often as possible. We try and minimize distractions when we're out there on the road, so we don't take full advantage of the screen. I'll be honest with you. We try and minimize distractions since we need to take good care of this baby.
But and just so people know that at this event, we can't turn the screens on. Right?
That is the case. So this is a pre-production vehicle that we're looking at right now. It is not a production-ready vehicle. So just for this event, we're keeping it powered down. We do want to keep a few secrets until the vehicle's launch. Now in the back, we can add additional screens. So this one here is obviously our captain's chair setup. If you choose for the captain's chairs, you're gonna have this beautiful center console with its own screen right back here to control, we call it the comfort screen. It controls the second and third rows climate control, the second rows heated and ventilated seats, if you have that option installed. And then it also controls the ambient lighting color. There are different colors to choose from on the interior's ambient lighting. Now there's an available option for rear seat entertainment screens that would be installed right here. They hang off the headrest. There's a pair of them, one on each headrest. It features Amazon Fire TV, meaning if you have an Amazon Prime account, you can stream all of your Amazon content straight to the rear screens. Now this glass that we have right here, you can see it has this beautiful copper colored coating on it. If you look through the vehicle, copper is the accent color when you get to the top of the line. There is copper accent stitching on the seats and as well as in the door panels with that soft touch material in the doors. So we wanted to continue that copper accent color. This coating on this glass is sort of like a polarized coating that you would have on a pair of polarized glasses. Normal window tinting, if you're inside trying to look out, well, it's just as dark as it looks like if you're standing outside. But with this, it looks mirrored from the outside, but from the inside, you still have fantastic visibility thanks to this special copper coating. Now, if you look around, there's also some more copper accents. We went to a great amount of detail designing this vehicle. So if you look on the raised Grand Wagoneer lettering that we have on the tailgate, you'll notice that copper color is also repeated right through here. So we have a sort of a brushed stainless steel on top with a copper bezel behind it. We continue to use that copper because, as we say in the premium market, premium repeats itself. So that copper color is going to be found all over the vehicle. There is an available bench in the second row, so it can be had as an 8-passenger vehicle. This one here is equipped as a 7-passenger vehicle. If you see up in the headliner there, we feature an awesome thing called the family cam. So the family cam is an ability for the driver to see the passengers at every single seating position. And what's interesting about that is the placement of the camera allows you to actually see an infant's face even if they are in a rear-facing child seat. So you can check in on the status of your infant even while they're in the back seat. It's driven by the Uconnect 5, which is the latest and greatest version of Jeep's Uconnect system. This one here is featuring a 12-inch screen. There is also a smaller screen. I believe it's 10 1/4 inches, but there's a smaller screen available as well. This has the largest screen up there, and it's being driven by Jeep's Uconnect 5 system. Now, this one does have the optional towing package on the back here. It's actually nice and flush with the bumper, so in some vehicles, you're gonna have a cutout that's permanent. Well, here, there are actually 3 fasteners on the bottom that you can unscrew with your hands, so no tools required. That's going to reveal our tow hitch. We're gonna have a 4-pin and a 7-pin connector for all different kinds of trailers. It also has a trailer brake gain right up by the steering wheel, so you can have trailer brake gain as you're driving your heavy loads behind you. So to me, the thing that stands out the most is how, even though it's a gigantic body-on-frame rear-wheel drive truck, it really feels like driving a large car. This one has the optional Quadra Lift suspension system on it, so it is constantly load leveling. If you turn hard to the left, your left suspension is going to inflate on that airbag, so it has minimal body roll, and it really feels like driving a large car rather than driving a truck. So when I drive the competition, the Escalades, the Navigators, they make you aware that you're operating a truck. If you steer to the left, the first thing that happens is the body rolls hard to the right, and that just doesn't happen in the Wagoneer. If you steer to the left, that right front suspension is going to inflate on the airbag to take that heavy load away from you. So we do sell it as 2 different models that are differentiated by the powertrain. There's a Wagoneer, which features that 5.7 liter. It is going to start at $68,590. This is the Grand Wagoneer with that 6.4 liter Hemi, and it is going to start at $87,590. Now, we are next to a Grand Wagoneer Series 3, which is the top of the line in the Grand Wagoneer trim. So this one is featured about $107,000 as displayed this evening.
That's a big responsibility to be driving a vehicle like that around the country that costs that much.
It sure is. That's why
you're also being spoiled.
That is true. So when I'm driving down the road, I'm constantly getting my back massaged because it has heated and ventilated massaging seats. And you can choose from different areas of massage to focus on. There is a lower back massage feature. There's one that we call rock climb, which sort of works your way up the whole of your back. So I get spoiled driving this around because I'm constantly getting a massage. As for availability, we are saying any day now. I can say that we have begun production on the actual models that will be available for sale. Now, they have not shipped yet, but we anticipate it showing up at your local dealership any day now. So there's always more to talk about. This vehicle has more than 120 standard and available safety features. So I could spend an hour just talking about the safety features that are on this vehicle. But if you do need more information, I would recommend you visit your local Jeep dealership. And this one right here, Goldstein, is having quite a party tonight. So come on by and see us.
Thank you for taking us on the tour.
My pleasure.
Introducing the all-new Wagoneer, redefining a premium SUV with an interpretation of classic style and modern design. Reserve your Wagoneer or Grand Wagoneer today with Goldstein Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram of Latham. GoldsteinCDJR.com.